Hey, it's Jeffrey Pepper Rogers here with another episode of Guitar Sessions. And I want to teach you today how to play John Prine's Hello in There. We are just past the 50th anniversary of his debut album, self-titled album, John Prine, which gave us so many amazing songs, not just Hello in There, but also Paradise and Sam Stone, Angel from Montgomery, which I taught back in episode 3 of the Guitar Session series. Quite a debut for a young songwriter with so many songs that are loved and covered often today. So Hello in There is a really nice piece of guitar finger picking, has more chords than your typical John Prine song, and is a really great one to work on. So let's dig in. And as with all the episodes of this series, you can find the tab and the charts and everything over on Patreon. I also, not too long ago, put together a big feature on John Prine's songs and guitar style for acoustic guitar. You can find all info about all this over on my website. So Hello in There sounds in the key of C, but I'm going to capo up at the 5th fret and play out of G shapes for this song. And let me just run through what chords we're going to run into here. G, which I tend to finger like this with my ring, middle, and pinky, although you could certainly do it this way as well. So there's our one chord is a G. A minor is our 2 chord. We have a D7, which is the 5. And then we have this shape, which looked at one way is a G major 7 over D. And but in this song, at least the way that I hear it, it actually serves as another chord too. You could look at this voicing as a B minor over D. And so in the charts that I've written out, I'm calling this a G major 7 over D in one place and a B minor over D in another. Then we also have a C. And another voicing, so that's our 4 chord, and then another voicing of D, which is a D over F sharp. So I got that 2nd fret note on the 6th string there. And those are all diatonic chords, meaning those are all chords that fall naturally in that key. But there's one exception, which comes up at the beginning of the chorus. That's the F shape. That is the flat 7, which kicks off the chorus and is a very attention-getting chord at that moment in the song. So a real important one from a harmonic perspective in there. And actually, I did a whole episode of Guitar Sessions on using the flat 7 chord to spice up chord progressions, so you might want to check that one out as well. But let's dig into the picking pattern for Hello in There. So John Prine typically played with a thumb pick and his bare fingers. I'm going to just use all bare fingers, no thumb pick for this. Just my preferred way of playing. And this is an alternating bass style, and really a great way to learn a song like this is to start off with the bass by itself and just make it really automatic, the motion with your thumb. Practice it over and over again until you don't even have to think about it and the thumb's on automatic pilot. And I've talked to a whole bunch of great finger pickers. Bruce Coburn comes to mind. Guitarists who talked about when they were learning, just sitting there while just for hours, just having their thumb go back and forth on chords. So that's totally ingrained. So a lot of John Prine music certainly built around that alternating bass picking. So we're going to go through this 4 bars at a time. I'm going to just start off with just the bass by itself and then add in the part with the fingers. All right, so starting with the first 4 bars of the verse, again, capo 5th fret, And I'm going to do the bass notes, the thumb part, by itself first. So we're going from G to A minor to D7 on this part. We'll go 1, 2, 3, 4. Once you got that all automatic, you can add in the finger notes, which either fall between the bass notes or sometimes on the same beat in a pinch. So that's when you play a note with your thumb and one with your finger at the same time. So here are those first four bars with the fingers added in. 1, 2, 3, 4. Moving along, next four bars go between G major 7 over D and C. So just the bass notes, we go 1, 2, 3, 4. So yeah, notice we had a little hammer-on onto the C at the end of that, which is a little John Prine thing that he liked to do. So here's that same part with the finger parts added in. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next four bars, going from G again to D over F sharp. So 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the bass notes alone. Add in the finger notes, and we get 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, then when we come to the chorus, we're hitting that F, that flat 7 chord, and we're going up to G. So the bass is just doing this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And just a sparse few other notes added in, we get this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next four bars, going back to this shape again, but I'm calling this a B minor over D. The reason is, if you listen to the recording with the other instruments, you can hear more of a B minor being suggested, especially by the bass. But it is actually the same shape, it's the same voicing that elsewhere I was calling a G major 7 over D. So here's the bass alone. 1, 2, 3, 4. get the other notes added in. One, two, three, four. And our last four bars here, just going between G and D over F sharp. Bass notes alone. One, two, three, four. And with the rest of it added in with the fingers, we get this. One, two, three, four. All right, and now I'm going to put those pieces together and play through the verse and then the chorus form, first a little slowly. One, two, three, four. Is a little more up to speed. One, two, three, four. So there are the basic parts of Hello in there. In the arrangement, he just uses the same basic picking pattern as an introduction, as an instrumental interlude, as he does in the verse. He does that in a whole bunch of his songs. One thing I would just say is, you know, you can look at the tab and find the pattern that way to practice, but just think about keeping the bass going. Think about the shapes being in the right shapes, but feel free to kind of make up your own little patterns. If you've got the bass steady, then you can just make up variations, playing notes with your fingers in between bass notes or along with the bass notes as pinches. Just create your own picking patterns that sound good to you. So there you go. Hello in there, John Prine. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you next time.